Dragons, is the ship ready?
We still have a little more work to do.
That's not my problem, is it? We sail for Burg immediately. We'll land here, under the cover of night.
Why aren't we taking the whole army?
We're not there to fight Stoic. We're there for one man, the Dragon Conqueror.
Oh, and you'll have him? We hear he's 10 feet tall with the strength of a dozen men.
Well, he shouldn't be too hard to find then, should he?
I'm telling you, I saw a pair of Zippleback feet in Mildew's house. He must have used them to make the footprints of the dragon who supposedly stole the boots.
Well then, let's go have a look at them.
Yeah, there's gonna be a problem with that. I also saw him throw them into the ocean.
I know you're upset about the dragon, son, but you're gonna need evidence to accuse a man of high treason.
Astrid, we'll prove Mildew did it. We have to if we ever want to see our dragons again.
I just hope they're okay. Why would one of our ships be anchoring there?
It's not one of our ships. I've got to tell Dad. Come on!
It's good to be back on the shores of Burg.
Good for you. Not so good for them.
Let's find this dragon conqueror.
This is no time to panic. That's what the outcasts are counting on.
Stoic!
Sven, did you get a count?
I saw 30 men at least, all armed to the teeth.
Without any weapons, we'll never be able to fight them head on.
No weapons! And outcasts on our shores! All thanks to your boy and his dragons.
I don't have time for this right now, Mildew. March! You and Bucket gather up the elders and the children. Get them to Thor's Beach. They'll be safe in the caves there.
We can help fight. We've been trained as warriors.
She may have been trained, but I was born a warrior.
Take this. It was Alvin's. But go.